Hi guys, this is Abhishek. In my previous video, I covered regarding the Gherkin, right? What exactly Gherkin means, how we are using in that acceptance criteria. So today in this video, we'll discuss about the Gherkin keywords. Let's get started. First is feature. So we have a number of user stories, right? NS per sprint. And so each user story will speak of one particular feature, right? So that feature we are going to write it in this, using this particular keyword. And coming to this next scenario, so in a given user story we'll be having all positive negative scenarios. So based on this feature user story, there'll be a one or two, or depends on till five, we'll be having a scenarios for that feature we need to test. So that scenarios we are going to cover here, and this scenario keyword, right? So we'll be explaining in this one what exactly we are covering, that let's say we are validating, what we are validating in that scenario. And in this scenario using we are using only single data to run against this one. So I'll write it down, single data. So we can run this scenario for only with respect to one data only. We cannot parameterize while we are using the scenario keyword. And coming to the steps when writing that for that particular given scenario, right? We need to write few steps to validation or prerequisite, so that we'll be covering using these keywords. So given is something a prerequisite or to put the system in a known state. So like navigating to the URL, or what all prerequisites we need to have it to get it ready for the testing. So that we'll be covering in given. And when is something we are performing an action or entering something into the fields, that all what all operations we perform in that web HTML, right? That we'll be having in a when. And then is like validation purpose. So let's say like we want to verify whether the logo is there or text is there, drop down values, that all will come under this then. And is an extension to all these ones, so we can use and with all this one extension to these things. And but coming to the but, right? We have negative scenarios. Let's say that element should not be present after logging in, or text should not be present. Those all things we'll use the but. And coming to the scenario outline, so we already have a scenario. Why you are going for scenario outline? So scenario outline will allow us to for data driven. We can achieve data driven using scenario. Let's say the same scenario you want to test with the multiple data, different types of data. Instead of hard coding multiple scenarios with the different type of data, we can parameterize the number of data for the same scenario. So that we can achieve using a scenario outline. And always whenever we are using a scenario outline, we should examples from here only we will be parameterizing the data. So let's say user and password, okay? So it is a one. So this is in this way we need to pass demo one and secret one. So you can run the same scenario. First it will be running for this one, next it will be running for this one. For that, in this scenario, wherever you are using this user and password fields, right, that should be in this format, user. You always keep capital letters, it will be better, okay? In the same way, password, okay. So this is how we are going to achieve data driven using scenario outline and example keywords. And coming to the background keyword, right? This is let's say what all common steps. What all common steps we have, right? That we can be written a background keyword. Let's say like you have three scenarios, okay? Three scenarios till login is common, let's say. So that all common keywords, given, when, so that you will be writing in a single and from then validation, all these things, right? That you will be writing in a each scenario. So there will be not a duplication of work for you by writing multiple things. So in that way, you use background keyword. So there are few extra keywords. So these all keywords we'll be using this in this feature, Cucumber feature file. So this is for doc string. So whenever you are using a parameters, right, that time you pass this symbol. So using this one as double quotes, you can hard code the values or parameterize the things. And for data tables, right, using this pipe symbol, as I told in examples, we are using this pipe symbols to have the parameterization passing from here to scenario outline and other tags. So I forgot this one. So what all tags, right? So in TestNG, you can have the group by concept, right? How you are grouping the your suit classes. So let's say regression or smoke or sanity. So whenever you are triggering from testng.xml file, those will pick up and run. In the similar way, you can use these tags. You can use at the whenever you are using these tags in above feature, this entire feature file will run no matter how many scenarios you have. So if you want to use only this particular scenario, you should write a tag above scenario, that scenario. Let me give examples, like few examples. So this is a sprint one user. This is up to you. You can write any name. I'm just telling sprint one or PI one or regression at the rate sanity. This is scenario specific. You can write your own names. Okay. So when you are running through JUnit, right, that time if you are passing these tags, what all feature files having these tags, right, it will pick and run for you. So this is about the tags, and this is, we use this one for commenting any particular line for us in a feature file, then these two will be commented. So using this one, I said, right, scenario outline, we are doing a data, we can achieve data driven. That time we need to give the symbols with a double quotes for a data to achieve data driven or parameterization from examples. So this is all about the Gherkin keywords, guys. If you like the video, please like, share and subscribe. Thanks.